So healthcare is one of the major sectors of the economy. We all engage in it in our daily lives, and it doesn't go away no matter if we're in a recession or the economy is really doing well. And for that reason, it's an important part of all investors' portfolios. Healthcare will continue to grow in terms of the amount of new treatments, companies, growth in spending, really because of the increase of population here in the U.S. and worldwide, but also, especially in the U.S., our demographics are getting older and older. These are all growth opportunities here in the U.S. for investors to take advantage of. So when you look at the healthcare landscape, there's really two pillars, if you will. The healthcare companies that might be the companies that you have health insurance from or hospitals, etc. The second pillar is really companies that help diagnose, treat, manage diseases. So these are pharmaceutical companies, biotechnology companies, medical device companies. And that tends to be where the real growth is because there's innovation. And that's very attractive from an investor standpoint because the growth there is potentially unlimited. In this area of high innovation, it's very important for investors to be diversified because oftentimes the innovation, while it's being tested, it's either approved or it's not approved. And that causes many of these companies to plummet in value based off those government testing results or potentially rocket up in value. So there are a variety of ways to invest in exchange traded funds, ETFs, in the healthcare and biotech area. The ETF generally offers portfolio diversification and transparency. You always know what you own. There's an ETF for generic drugs. There's an ETF that targets obesity-related stocks. There's a cancer immunotherapy ETF. There's a general biotechnology ETF. There's a pharmaceutical ETF. There are many ways investors can express their bullishness on these areas. The healthcare ETFs that are higher growth in nature also carry higher risk and higher volatility, so investors need to be aware of it. So 20 years from today, healthcare investing in the growth side is going to be quite different. My guess is there's going to be companies that have wearable devices that not only diagnose and monitor you, but potentially inject or treat you for your current conditions. I think there's going to be more robotics involved in healthcare than there is today. And I think investors could benefit from having exposure to that because it'll add an extra layer of growth to their overall core holdings.